keep silent mode on. This thing looks like you just Frankenstein the other four robots together. And you're cheering for this. I will see if I can make it dance!
Black bear? White bear? Hell nah! I'm my own bear!
As expected of a final boss, this one's different than the other robots. Do our best with the boom boom and beat this thing with a kablam! The vulgar one came out!
Ooh, neat.
Gotta aim for him!
You should try hard. Do you really want to save the adults that badly? Do you really want the burden of hope on your shoulders?
Drill. One day is 24 hours? Ah, too damn short. We need some insomnia, because sleep is the cousin of death.
I see your other weak point.
Who's a bad boy? Who's a good boy? Who's a normal boy? Hey, don't shoot! I was just about to go donate to charity! Yo! Oh, can I give thanks to my fam with a sick rap?
Ow!
This is for the sake of... I forgot his name, that hero guy who got bullied by adults!
Yeah, you know the fucking drill. Who's a good boy? Who's a normal boy?
I can't aim up in air.
Hey, don't shoot! I was just about to go donate to charity! Yeah, you know the fucking drill.
Can't make him dance.
Huh? Is Monica about to lose? No.
That was much too easy. And yes, thank you for the follow. That happened while I was in the middle of a boss fight. Unfortunately, no dancing for Kurokuma. That was a little too easy. But at least we get to launch him out a window. Game. Thank you.
Huh?
Unhappy landings.
Monica lost?
Yes, you lost.
That's right. Now, be a good little girl and just give up.
Gonna be killed? I don't wanna die.
No, there's no way I'd kill you. Of course not. But if you don't hand over that controller, it will not be pleasant.
No, that's no good. If this controller is destroyed, Monica's plan will fail. And if that happens, Monica can no longer be the successor.
That's enough! Just hurry up and hand it over, or I swear I will spank you good!
Oh, fine.
If I break this, the Monokumas stop, and the brainwashing helmets will deactivate, right? And then this uprising will be over. But that was... well, it was kind of easy. Is it really
that
okay?
That boss fight was not all that difficult.
Ramen broth and climaxes should always be light.
Says you.
Or would you prefer an ending that has us getting beaten up and thrown from one despair to another? Just like your older brother.
No, that boss fight was easy.
I don't want that, but... well, you're forgetting the real happy ending comes after we rescue Master.
Not for us.
So let's hurry up and end this. It's really okay to break this, right? It's obviously okay. You can stop the Monokumas and the brainwash gets lifted. Right.
It's giving me a choice? I get a choice? And let's write that. We just saved not too long ago. Let's write this out. See what happens.
What are you doing? Sorry, something is concerning me. Concerning you?
Concerning you? Concerning or disconcerting? Could it be that maybe you want to be Monica's ally at the last minute? So you're
No need to hesitate! Break the controller! End this already! You're right.
Nose! Please wait!
Kodoko? Yep.
You? Why are you here?
Don't break the controller! Yay! Kodoko, you came to save me! Shut up! Breaking the controller would also end the brainwashing. That would be bad. If it's just the Monokumas, that's fine. But the kids, we'd lose all the friends we made. If that happens, I'm gonna be all alone.
What friends? You brainwashed them.
But even then, I don't want to be alone. Please, Brittany, please don't take my friends away.
Kotoko's right. Don't break that controller. If you don't, I promise, I'll kill all of the adults and build paradise.
Not exactly what I would hope for. Most of the time, but all the adults you're going to kill, I don't think I have a problem with it.
Shut your mouth, traitor!
Kotoko, why are you saying such mean things? We're friends.
No, we're not! You're just a traitor who killed your own friends!
Oh, please. Please forgive me. It's just forgive and forget. Live in the now.
To be fair, kind of hard to represent tears and drool otherwise. The speaking explosion type things they especially gave to Kurokuma, though, they probably could have gone a different way with that, but you know.
Let's kill adults together again!
Shut up! Be quiet! Die!
What's going on?
Just let those idiots fight. Hurry up and break the controller!
No! Stop! Please, leave me just some hope! I'll even settle for just a little!
What hope? You really think there's hope for you guys?
Miss Komaru Naeki, please listen to Monika's request too. Please, make the right choice. If you don't choose right, you're gonna replay this moment over and over. So make the correct choice and end this properly.
Correct choice?
Yep, we've got a save back at the first choice.
Komaru? What happened?
Huh? You're not gonna break it? That's weird. Why not? Didn't you want to stop those crazy kids? Didn't you want to be the heroine of this dirty, lame penal colony? Didn't you want to be everyone's hope? Just like your brother?
I...
Are you sure? If you don't break the controller now, this will just repeat over and over.
Hold on a second. This is backwards. Why do you suddenly want her to destroy the controller?
Ignore her! It's okay! You didn't make a mistake at all!
Kotoko, give it up. Watch the controller get destroyed.
Shut up! You be quiet!
Toko, what should I do?
I will leave that decision to you. However... Because I'm leaving it to you, I will share the responsibility as well. So, just do what you think is best.
What I think is best.
It's getting bigger. I'm riding this train.
I don't think it's a good idea to break it. At least, not right now.
That's right. Good. Thank you, Big Sis. Thank you so much for not breaking Monica's special controller.
Geez, which side are you on?
Yeah, Heiji is easily the least likable character in this game. He is the most unlikable. Everyone else at least has some redeeming qualities.
Before all the cast was here.
Cast?
He'll be here soon. Probably running down the hallway right now. See? His hand's on the door!
Our fourth wall.
Found
There's nothing left
Monica.
Of it.
See? Just like Monica said! Bullseye! We do have a sibling connection after all!
You? Why are you here?
Big Brother came to save Monica, right? You're being so mean. Everybody's bullying Monica. Monica's getting picked on by the kids and the adults. Isn't that awful?
Yeah, Channel Frederator doesn't always get it right. But I can see them trying to design her to be the most hated character. But yeah, Heiji easily takes that crown in just about every way.
Big Brother, save Monica!
Don't tell me that's what you're actually here for!
Don't be an idiot! Who the hell's gonna save you?
Big Brother?
Stop calling me that! You're not my sister!
Now, if it gives me the option to break the controller over his head...
You're just the old man's mistake. I didn't want you around. I never thought of you as family.
Why? Why are you being so mean? Monica's just a child.
You're no child. You're a brat who never learned her place. And now it's biting you in the ass. It's over, Monica. I'm finishing this now.
Please, stop, Big Brother. I'm scared.
Mr. Heiji...
So that's the controller for the Monokumas.
Huh?
What are you doing? Hurry up and destroy it! End this nightmare already!
Yeah, he actually says that Toko is too old for him to be interested in.
Please stop! If you destroy the controller, all of Monica's hard work will be wasted!
No, when they're in the factory on their way to go get the Big Bang Monokuma, he out and out says that Toko is too old for him. He likes him as young as possible.
I won't be able to create the successor. I won't be able to inflict despair on the world.
How crazy are you? Now hurry! Hurry and destroy it!
I know, but...
Don't! You can't destroy it! This is some kind of trap!
Destroy it! Destroy it, Komaru!
What's going on?
Well, the PSP version is not the only version out there. In the Steam version, he admits to being a pedophile. Oh yeah, we're riding this train.
I'm glad you understood
us. We got too many of the wrong people telling us to smash this controller.
What is this? Why are you siding with those brats?
I'm not siding with them or anything.
Did you forget what they did? If that's the case, then shut up and listen.
Listen?
Destroy.
Yeah, he is a pedophile, and there ain't much coming back from that.
What is this?
All this time, the people outside were watching. They saw you defeat Monica's robot.
But what drove them to kill people? Why did they decide they needed their paradise? Why was Junko able to so easily swoop in and convince them? Because they were so heavily abused by the adults in their lives. With Kotoko on screen, this takes special significance. In her case especially, and with him being a pedophile, this ties into her almost directly, that we had some severe abuse going on to these five Warriors of Hope. The only way they felt they could do anything was to get revenge like this. So yeah, the kids killed people, but what caused them to kill people in the first place? The abuse they suffered at the hands of the adults twisted them pretty badly. The adults brought this on themselves.
What? You did this, didn't you? You're filming all of this!
Huh? Monica has no idea.
They're still watching. They're waiting for you to destroy that controller. Everyone expects it from you. They're waiting for you to wake them up from this nightmare. You showed us hope. We were able to finally stand up to those brats because of your speech. That's why I'm even here. That's why I'm not afraid of these kids anymore. It's all thanks to you. You are hope itself to us.
Nagito isn't in the game enough to be hated more than Heiji.
But if you still can't make up your mind, I'll just have to help you choose. Tell them what you've done. Everything. The whole truth. Then there's no way they'd side with you.
Everything?
The reason why you want a successor. Everything. Tell them the truth, or I'll make sure you regret it.
Fine. I'll talk.
Yeah.
It all started when I was still attending the Hope's Peak Academy Elementary School. Monica did a little prank to convince the Warriors of Hope to commit suicide.
I've seen Danganronpa 3 Future Side personally.
Wait! What?! That was a prank?!
Oh, of course. Monica didn't intend to end her own life at all. But you all took it so seriously. And around then, Monica met Big Sis Junko with the most miraculous timing. The moment Monica saw her, Monica understood. Big Sis Junko is light itself that will shine down on Monica's boring little world. It's a miracle! Thank you, God! At least, at the time I thought it was a miracle. But later I learned it was inevitable. She came into my life just to take advantage of me.
Take advantage?
Probably still shouldn't talk about the Danganronpa 3 anime because there could still be people here and people that watch this video in the future that haven't seen it and are waiting for the game to come out before they look at the anime. So let's not talk about it.
By then, Monica was already a chief executive at Toa Group's robotics branch. Oh, Big Brother, I'm sorry about that. Wasn't it painful to watch your little sister surpass you? And I'm also sorry to you, Kotoko. You didn't want to hear that little truth, did you? Big Sis Junko only cared about Monica. The other Warriors of Hope were just bonuses.
Don't make stuff up! Big Sis loved us all!
Love? What are you talking about?
And yeah, you really don't come off well if you're trying to defend Heiji. Especially if you know what he's done. A GTA streamer, huh? I can never seem to get that game to work that well. I have to minimize it too much. I could never stream GTA.
There's no way someone would love you. Your own parents didn't even love you.
Enough. Just keep talking.
Gotta love torture.
I'm sorry, I got it! Stop, Big Brother! At first, Big Sis Junko was looking for a corporation that could mass-produce machines. So that she could use them for the tragedy. That's why, to meet her expectations, Monica started making all the Mr. Monokumas. Concentrating all of the resources of Toa Group's robotics branch.
And just what was everyone else at Toa doing? Why did no one stop you?
I lied. To Papa and Big Brother. I told them I was building robots that could be domestic helpers and emergency aid workers.
And the adults actually bought that story?
No, it's more like we turned a blind eye. She was the outsider in our family, but she's tenacious, with a genius intellect. As long as she kept earning Toa Group money, we let her do whatever she wanted. This brat took advantage of her position and started mass-producing these monsters on her own. I didn't know what the machines were even for, so as usual, I let her be. But I did think they had a weird design.
And thanks to that, Monica made Big Sis Junko so happy. She started using them for the incident.
Yeah, Monokumas could potentially be domestic bots. Potentially. It would take some severe modifications.
That's what helped the incident get bigger and bigger.
That's when the old man finally realized what was up. And when he tried to stop you.
It's a little too late to stop producing the Monokumas anyway, right? If we stopped, Big Sis Junko would reveal the whole thing. She would make it known that Toa Group built all those murder machines. And if she did that, Toa Group's finished.
Monica, are you threatening me?
Jeez, Papa, that's not it. It's more like a business opportunity.
Extortion?
This little bitch sold us the idea of making a weapon to fight the Monokumas.
You made them, and then you sold the weapons to fight against them as well?
Good little cogs in the military-industrial complex.
The more out of hand the situation got, the more profitable Toa became.
Hm! Just what a filthy demon would do!
We didn't have a choice. We were in too deep. If we went against the Despair Group, they'd reveal what Monica did under Toa's name. Then Toa makes enemies with both forces. We'd be shunned. Go extinct.
And this is bad. How?
Anyways, Toa Group did the right thing and chose to coexist with the Despair. And to the public, they looked like heroes fighting against the incident. But behind the scenes, they were working for both sides. The reason that air purifier they developed was so effective was because they were part of the cause in the first place. That's why the incident didn't hit them as hard. Those idiot adults didn't know that, so they worshipped Toa Group like they were saviors. But you better not blame this all on me. By the end, even Papa was into it.
So now we have, you know, a little reasoning why they would decide to slander the Future Foundation and, you know, drive a lot of distrust against the group that could actually come in and solve the problems without creating them.
He supported the incident for money and honor. He ended up being a patron of Big Sis Junko.
Toa Group? Junko Enoshima's patron? So that's why you distanced yourself from Future Foundation. You didn't want to get found out.
No matter how rotten it is, Toa Group is still my legacy. I want to protect it.
Head go squish.
But the good times had to end eventually. Just when things were gonna get much, much more fun, Big Sis Junko died. All thanks to your brother, Miss Komaru Naegi. Since then, Future Foundation gained power, and Big Sis's influence got weaker and weaker. Monica tried her best to rebuild it by any means necessary. But Papa just said it's over, and gave up. Like all the fickle, wishy-washy adults do. Papa betrayed Big Sis. No matter what Monica said, Papa just wouldn't listen anymore.
You couldn't forgive him for that, could you? That's why you targeted this city.
That's what you told us, right?
All we gotta do is fulfill the hopeful dream Big Sis Junko gave us. We shouldn't give up. We can't abandon hope. We need to build a paradise, and take revenge against the adults who betrayed us. Monica is so grateful to the Warriors of Hope. Adults are dirty demons who killed Big Sis. You guys killed them off so well for me. I was so happy. It was just as I thought. Kids are so simple-minded. The truth is, Monica didn't really care about things like revenge and paradise. Succeeding Big Sis's will was far more important. Monica doesn't want Junko Enoshima's legacy to end.
So that's how you came to the brilliant conclusion that you should become the successor?
And in order to become the successor, what exactly did you do?
Big Sis used to say all the time, that she wanted to paint the world with despair. If someone could do that, don't you think they would make the best successor ever?
What do you mean?
War.
Huh?
Causing war. If a war breaks out, the world topples back into despair, right?
War? What are you talking about, brat?
You're bluffing. You're trying to trick us again, aren't you? You've got some ulterior motive.
If you think so, Why don't you just break that controller Ms. Komaru has? Break the controller and start a war.
Wait, why would a war break out if this controller is destroyed?
It's very possible, yes. It's very possible that she is referencing America.
I told you she's bluffing. She's just using reverse psychology.
Oh, hey, don't call Monica a liar. You told me to talk.
I told you to tell the truth, not spew more of your lies. Enough of this. No more talk. Destroy that controller right now!
Huh?
Hey, what are you doing? Don't tell me you seriously trust what this kid said.
I don't know, seems pretty logical if you look at it from her point of view.
Wait, no! I can't break it yet!
We haven't gotten all the plot!
So, you're taking this little brat's word over mine?
Yeah, pretty much.
It's not like that!
But please wait! I remember!
Remember what?
A while ago, Monica and Kuro Kuma were having a secret talk. I was listening in.
What are you talking about? Get to the point.
The next choices are actually going to be in Japanese.
At the time, I thought they were kidding, but maybe they weren't. If that's the case,
and upside down.
This is very bad.
What are you talking about?
The Monokuma heads the kids are wearing. They're linked to the Monokuma's power source.
Ta-da!
If that power source is cut off, the helmets explode.
Explode?
The controller, the Monokuma stop, but all the Monokuma heads will blow up, and then headless children everywhere.
And there's the rub.
Oh, come on, an exploding helmet? You expect us to believe that made-up bullshit?
But I'm serious. I heard them say it. You know Monica would totally pull something like that. She betrayed the Warriors of Hope! She could do it without even feeling guilty about it! So mean, Kotoko! Making me out to be the bad guy! Monica doesn't want the controller to be destroyed! Bitch!
A rift in the group now, huh? Well, if you're both lying, you need to get your story straight.
No, I'm serious! I heard it!
That's enough! Destroy that thing already.
No! Never, ever destroy that controller!
Aww. It didn't give me Japanese.
Hey, what are you doing? Why aren't you destroying it?
Because the children might die if I do.
They're bluffing. I've been trying to tell you.
But even if there's a small chance they're not, I can't do it. The kids wearing those helmets, they're just being brainwashed. None of this is their fault. Not everyone involved was doing this of their own will.
I plan to reload and break the controller right off the bat, yes.
Brainwashing? Are you serious? Who the hell cares about that?
Huh?
After all this, that excuse is not gonna fly! Even if they all died, they had it coming!
No, you have it coming.
You've seen what they did to us! They deserve it!
You can't be serious. You're just blinded by revenge!
Maybe I am!
But how could I not be? After what they did to us. Not even the harshest revenge is enough to make me forget what I've been through. Listen. Listen outside. The screams of the adults, the ones who lost everything. Our loved ones were butchered by those little brats. They took everything from us. But you were the one who told us to stand and fight, right? It's because of your speech that we're even here right now. If you really are our ally, then finish this.
Yeah, not feeling too sorry for the adults here.
You're our hope. Please, don't betray us. Destroy the controller, please. Please, just end this for us. We just want it to be over.
Hold on a minute. You can't fool me.
Me?
No, idiot. You. I'm talking to you.
Hmm? Are you talking to Monica?
I get it now. What you meant by war. You're trying to start a war between Toa City and Future Foundation.
What?
The children are killed. What would Future Foundation do when they found out? They'd think the adults who survived were behind it. And then they'd find out Toa Group was involved with manufacturing the Monokumas. From that evidence, I'm guessing Future Foundation would think the adults were remnants of despair. And if that happens, Future Foundation would crush this town immediately.
Boom, boom, boom!
That's the idea, isn't it?
Nope. That's not quite it. Cause it won't just end with a war between Toa and Future Foundation. Huh? Future Foundation isn't the only one who'd see the adults as remnants of despair. The true remnants of despair that are spread all over the world, they'd learn about the war in Toa City and they'd come charging in. Toa City would become the heart of a resurgence of the despair that Bix's Junko left us. Worthy of the name of Junko Enoshima, wouldn't you agree?
Are you serious with this?
She can't be. She's bluffing anyway. Even if it were true, all you'd have to do is explain the situation to Future Foundation, right? And you're with them, right, Toko? I mean, you could straighten this all out easily.
I don't know. Because the city shares a past with the incident. They won't take any chances. The moment they see the headless bodies of children in the streets, it's over. They wouldn't even care about their hostage or Miss Toko's testimony, don't you think?
What?
Child victims have quite an impact on people.
Not as much as you'd think, sadly.
It's just like I said from the beginning. Pitiful children are the most powerful.
I mean, Sandy Hook is still considered a false flag by many.
So that was your plan. You need the adults to take revenge so they will cause more child victims. You chose adults with no children because you thought they'd kill the kids with no remorse.
I mean, adults with no children wouldn't have a single bit of mercy, would they?
Wait, then. We were sorted and kept alive.
You used Kamaru to incite the adults to take revenge against the kids, didn't you?
Huh? Yeah, that is the main problem with Danganronpa Ultra Despair Girls. There's a good story buried in it, But they put so much heinous stuff. It makes it very not fun to get through. To get to that story.
Monica may have helped things along, but Miss Kamara's transformation was her own doing. That delicate little girl maturing, growing to overcome the despair as hope itself. You even grew to care about this town, wanting to save it, becoming the hope for the adults. But even so, you know hope isn't always a good thing. At times, hope can be a terrible burden. It can be a drive to hurt others, just like now.
And she's still being the master manipulator here.
What did you think would happen if you gave people who watched their loved ones die hope? Did you think they'd all be positive, working together nice and peacefully? Of course not! They will turn into demons. Demons who live for revenge. You see? Just listen to them.
Destroy that controller for so long.
What?
Those people out there don't care whether or not the heads of the children are gonna explode. Rather, they sound pretty excited about it, don't you think? That's the sound of people who have completely transformed into demons. And this is all your fault, Big Sis.
Me?
It's because you stirred up the adults. It's your hope that turned them into demons, you know? So that makes it all your fault, Miss Komaru Naegi.
What are you talking about? It's not Komaru's fault, it's yours!
Wait! Listen to what she's saying! If what she said is true, then she should have wanted to destroy the controller right away. She could have just destroyed the damn thing herself. Then she would have her war.
No, that wouldn't do. That would not be worthy of the successor now, would it?
She can stand?
Oh yeah, you missed that vault and dismount from her room.
She stood. Monica stood up?
That's not important right now. Not just the city, but the whole world. How could this happen?
So anyways, what are you gonna do, hmm? How are you gonna end this? Are you gonna kill the children and play the savior? Or are you gonna spare the children's lives and let them keep slaughtering the adults? Who lives? Who dies? That is your choice. There's no way to save both. One side has to die. And you're going to kill them. Now, it's about time you made your final choice. The final choice you can make as Komaru Naegi. Choose wisely!
Riding that train.
No. No, it's impossible. I can't break it.
No. You're gonna break it, all right. Monica knows.
Huh?
You're gonna destroy the controller, and then the children's heads are gonna explode. And that's when the war begins. And the successor, a new splendid symbol of despair, will be born!
You don't know that! And like, there's no way I'd ever accept you as a successor in the first place! There's no way you can be a vessel of Big Sis Juko!
I don't think she's talking about herself there, Kotoko.
Kotoko, when did I ever say that Monika wanted to be the successor?
Huh?
Monika's not the one who's going to be the successor. It's gonna be Miss Komaru Naegi.
Yep. And it would be nice if we could use this controller to actually control things. Maybe even send out a shutdown command to all the helmets without exploding them. That type of thing. We have the controller.
Paint the world with despair. That's what Big Sis Junko always used to say, you know? What could be more despair-inducing than having Makoto Naegi's sister be the successor? So, the one who's gonna murder all these kids has to be Miss Komaru herself.
What are you saying?
Oh, don't worry. It's not hard. All you have to do is destroy the controller. I've already prepared cameras so that the moment is recorded and sent to Future Foundation. With Monika's video message as a bonus set! Monika already declared that Miss Komaru Naegi will succeed the legacy of Big Sis Junko!
What do you mean? Why would I...
Like I said, don't listen to her! She's just trying to keep you from destroying it!
Big brother, you've just been saying that over and over. Adults don't like change.
You shitty little brat! Enough! Give me the controller. I'll destroy it myself!
But if we do that, the children will die!
What else are we supposed to do? We have to end this massacre. What about all the adults who died? Are we just going to forget about them?
Don't go dragging us into your revenge! Komaru has nothing to do with this!
That's right! There's no reason to kill them! You don't have to be a part of this one bit!
No need, no reason, no relation. That's the difference between Big Brother and Miss Komaru. This isn't personal for her. But I knew that might be a problem, so Monika made sure to make a special request. To get Miss Komaru to want revenge, I needed help from her parents. Now come on over here. Let's open the gates of hell with Monika. You too, Mom and Dad. The climax is gonna start soon. Your child will be born again as the successor to Junko and Oshima.
God, she's creepy.
What do you mean, revenge?
Are you ready for this? Take a body break? Get a list of insults ready for Monika? Have you mentally prepared yourself to surrender to despair, unable to suppress the urge to kill? Then I'll show you!
What? More bodies again? You don't have to show them, you know. I'm already well aware how terrible you are.
After all this, you're still showing off killing adults? How crazy are you?
Yeah.
Komaru.
I'm surprised that nobody else figured this out.
She probably wrote the message on the floor with her dying breath. But when she collapsed, the blood stuck. That's how those letters ended up on her skirt.
Komaru? Makoto?
Did you notice? She wrote the names of her children before she died. You have such loving parents. I'm jealous. Family love. It sounds so nice. Something I've never felt my whole life.
Lies. It's just a lie. Those bodies. No, it couldn't be. There's no way. Normally, a dying message is something like writing the killer's name.
Oh, that's not a very convincing argument at all. You can't refute me like that.
That's a lousy truth bullet.
You hate me, don't you? You hate me, right? I played with the bodies of your family like toys, and now you want to kill me, right?
Well, I'm not so sure about that.
Oh, now you believe her.
You said your parents are missing, right?
Hey, what are you...
Showing it to you right now, like this? That means it's gotta be true, without a doubt.
I have a feeling... Well, that wasn't her full name. That was her and her brother's names. Komaru and Makoto. That was both of their names. Not just... I mean, she didn't write out Naegi anywhere in there.
Now, are you gonna just forget the fact that this bitch murdered your own parents? Shame on you! Can't think of them as children. They're not anymore. They're the ones who are demons. Destroy that controller and finish it! Kill them all! Not just for your sake, or your parents' sake, but for everyone who was murdered!
Hold on. We can't just do something like that. It's fine. Komaru? If you want me to destroy it that much, I'll do it. I said hold on! Calm down and think carefully, Shut up!
And she snapped.
Who cares anymore? No matter what happens to adults, no matter what happens to children! No matter what happens to this town! No matter what happens to the world! I don't give a damn anymore! I don't give a damn! Komaru? Togo? I'm sorry, I... It's impossible. I can't become like Makoto.
This is all determined from the very start. The hope you felt was just for the sake of making you feel the worst kind of despair. I knew from the beginning that you would fall into despair.
So, are you gonna give me my choice? See, I can break the controller, or I can break the controller. Well, they never made it to the point where they were upside down or written in foreign languages. But let's go ahead and pick the one we don't just start with the cursor on anyway. Okay, so we just had a scene where we had to walk Toko towards Komaru. Okay.
What are you doing? Outsiders have no business interrupting us.
I'm not an outsider. We're friends.
Aww.
Stop shouting nonsense. Just hand that over!
No! I won't give it to you! I need to protect this controller! I need to for Komaru's sake!
What are you talking about? She was going to destroy it!
That's not how she really feels. I'm sure she's actually thinking that she doesn't want to do it.
Huh. How the hell could you possibly know that?
I don't know how! I just know!
Huh?
I've been told you weren't the type to interfere. That's why I chose you to take on the role of escort. But it appears that the information Mr. Servant provided was false. So, how about this? That's right! It's the key to the room where Mr. Byakuya Togami is locked inside! Say, you want to trade this key for that controller? If you do, you can go home with Mr. Byakuya Togami!
You're telling me to choose between Komaru and Master?
Now it's your turn to make a choice.
That is playing dirty.
Fine then. Hand over Master's key.
I knew you'd do it! Now, why don't you just hand me that controller?
No, not gonna happen.
Huh?
Because I'm taking Komaru home with me as well.
What are you saying? You gotta make a choice, that's the rules.
Who cares about your damn rules? You want me to make a choice? There's no way I could ever make that choice. I wouldn't choose one and leave the other behind. Both are important to me. So, I'll definitely protect both.
What the heck? That's just unreasonable.
Enough already, just hand over that controller! I'll crush it!
I'll never hand it over!
Do you want me to hurt you even more?
Hurt? That means nothing to me. I'm sure you don't understand, since you have plenty of disposable friends, but I finally made a friend in Komaru, and I'm not going to hurt my friend, so I'll never hand it over.
Shut up!
Toko, you have a stun
gun.
Keep the
kids under control and end
this
nightmare.
Hit him or you
with it. This is the only
way!
It.
Yeah, almost forgot about you. He is kind of pretty.
Why is it moving?
Monika has no idea. The only ones who can control Big Bang Monokuma are you and Mama. You are the ones who programmed it that way.
How?
We can make exceptions for his prettiness in the event of Genocyber Show showing up.